This is a recently opened Heart of Darkness box and Charlie Pin of another one over here. I still get a thrill out of these color patterns. Sometimes you get very lucky in these variations and they're quite nice. In the most recent Heart of Darkness, there's an addition to the instruction insert. This is it's basically Noodler's newest addition, our smallest bottle, if you will. Has a screw-on cap and a seal. And it's pretty much the smallest volume that we have as a container. It states on the side that it is a reloadable 308 cartridge. And that's cartridges started with fountain pens with Civil War veterans, and then a few more were tried with World War I veterans, and then a lot were tried with World War II veterans. And that's when the modern disposable cartridge came out of that generation. This is somewhat of a throwback. The first cartridge comes from the prior century, the 19th century, from the Eagle Pencil Company. They had a fountain pen that had a glass, refillable, reloadable cartridge. And that used to have a cork on the front. You'd remove the cork, and then you'd insert it into the section. This design is made out of a durable plastic, a biodegradable plastic. It's the same plastic that the Charlie pin is made out of. And I've demonstrated driving a vehicle over one. I've demonstrated sending it down the barrel of a 10-gauge shotgun. Some of you might have seen this before. This actually dates to just before World War II. It's one of many parts pens made out of the same material. And unlike other Mandarin yellows of the era, the color retention is fairly good with this type of plastic. And it's not that crack prone. In fact, I could still step on this and it would survive. It's tough stuff. And though if you smashed it with your foot or you could damage this, you could get it to leak. It won't spurt out the way some of the universal cartridges do, though, if you were to step on it. The top unscrews, has a little seal. You can screw it onto the end. Takes a little more than 3 squeezes to fill it. Right up to the threads. And I will demonstrate. You want the O-ring to have flattened sides. Flattened sides indicate that it's formed a complete seal on both sides. Let's see here. There's a bit of an impression. You can see the grip texture. You can get it to break. I like them so much, though, that I am not going to send it down the barrel of a shotgun. So that's not going to be done this video. If you want to see something like that, you can look at another video on this channel that does that. Just took the filler off this Ahab. Hold the cartridge pointing up to the ceiling. A little difficult doing that with being in front of the camera. That is one thing about a reloadable cartridge, that if you have it open and you point it this way while it's open, it will leak. Okay. Tighten the end a little bit. See, there's ample space in the Ahab so that it doesn't even rub against that O-ring seal. Now, I've been doing that so long, I can almost hear my second grade teacher saying, look at what a lack of productivity you have. Just doodling. I think she's still alive, if she is watching. I actually do this for a living now. The 308 cartridge, if it's well cared for, it should last as long as your pen. There's no reason to ever throw it out. It's written right on it, reloadable, so that it is not considered a disposable item. The last thing in the world I would have wanted having this made would be for people to just buy them and when they're empty toss them out. We're going to try to make them very affordable, but they are not going to be free. I've looked at some recent cartridge prices and I was a bit shocked. I felt as if my wallet had the potential to have been accosted by the price tags, and this is probably going to cost less than those cartridges, most of them. Empty. You fill it up with your favorite ink. It's another reason to get a dropper bottle. And I hope that the economics do not cause people to think it's cheap enough, I'll just throw it away. Please don't do that. you can develop a set of them and keep your favorite colors in them. There are many purposes. There's, for instance, the Ahab brush pen. I should note, has been sold. I believe all of these are now being shipped with an inkball feed. If you notice, the inkball feed does not fit the threads of the Ahab. However, right behind those threads, here, in this part of the section, with a firm twist, you can get it to grip the plastic there. Because the tolerance is close enough, you can actually get it to grip there. I would suggest only using it this way. You do not require much pressure to write with these. You might have to use a piece of rubber to grip it, to screw it in and screw it out. You're not going to be able to fill much with the self-filling unit because there is no breather tube. Now this was mint, and you might notice that once it has been screwed in, it formed a pattern, and the tolerances are that close. Holding it up, of course. I envision some people aren't going to do that. I apologize in advance, but flattened sides to the O-ring. If it's very tight, it will be straight. Occasionally these need tapping. This one actually had some water in it. If you ever have cleaned one and you want to get the water out, just write on a paper towel and it will bleed it out, and it will get your replacement ink into the inkball feed. And now with this 308 reloadable cartridge, you now have a reloadable Ahab rollerball. This is, it's meant for you to tinker with. They're included free with each Ahab brush pen. It's really hope that you'll use the brush pen for highlighting. I'm going to have a quick time-lapse demonstration of this pen as a brush pen, using the 308 cartridge, and showing how you can switch with a bowl of water between the colors and rinse it out relatively quickly using your fill unit. You keep the fill unit nearby when you're operating with the brush unit, and remember to always line up your breather tube with the center of the unit, and you'll be able to use it for multiple colors, and you could have quite a potential. Noodlers will eventually be making a case for these 308 cartridges. In the meantime, I would suggest that there are a lot of very affordable 1930s cigarette cases, a lot of them in beautiful celluloids, in sterling silver and vermeil, and you can find them in antique shops for surprisingly affordable prices. Some things are available online. This is actually from a recycle bin. Happens to carry a different type of 308 cartridge, and it happens to work for fountain pen 308 cartridges. Found that when I have experimented with making an Ahab rollerball, that each time I've done this, it has it's gotten easier, and you wind up with two sets of threads on your Ahab. Okay, this is a brush feed that I've been using with highlighter inks for about a year. And occasionally I use black in the same feed. Wind up using it as a marking pen of a sort. It fills in spaces very, very quickly. So that's the Ahab brush pen as both a rollerball and a brush pen, and the quick highlighter demonstration. Now, in case you're wondering about these, they're highlighter inks. This is known simply as Orange, ORG. For short, it's literally ORG on the label. These are exclusively in 4.5 eyedropper bottles. This is the Year of the Golden Pig. These are highlighter inks that tend to hug the border of the line they make, and you can put other inks through them to a better degree. Say you're drawing black through them, and they won't mix. It's about as close to a solvent-based property highlighter as you can get while not using a solvent, while still being water-based. The risk of offending dog people, I use this example of a pro-cat article. Another pen that automatically has a rollerball with it is the tortoiseshell brush pen. This particular model has a brush pen and an ink ball, with every single one that's sold If these ever skip, it's because there's a tiny air bubble inside there. You just want to gently tap them to get the air bubble to move and enable the ink to flow again. Doesn't happen that often with these, though. I've also tried to get these to wear out using a writing machine as well as just personal use, and I haven't gotten one of these newer points. These replaced what we had before, and they haven't worn out. They just keep going. I've been very happy with them. Reason for inky fingers. Most people would probably rinse out the pen first before they did this, but I just want to demonstrate the utility of this pen. You could use that just for writing, but you could also fill it with a highlighter ink, Firefly for instance. Conrad brush can be much finer. It's a Japanese style brush. The Ahab brush can be very fine, but it also can be extremely bold and fill in massive areas very quickly because it's a bigger brush. This ink actually looks like a sort of port wine. It's bottled one bottle at a time. There's some variation one should expect in it, with the attempt to be each bottle is unique. It's a fairly deep burgundy. American aristocracy. The apology to King George for having any American aristocrats. There's been a write-up on it. And this is Royal Military Governor of Massachusetts, Thomas Gage, His Majesty King George III of the United Kingdom, made in the second colony after Virginia, given that Virginia was first. And over in England, they also have Brexit, another apology to poor King George III. And both were released pretty much simultaneously on American aristocracy being released on both sides of the Atlantic. This color is known as Victory Garden. It's sometimes a teal bluish green mixed with a honey yellow in acrylic. And it has ceased to be manufactured and is eventually no longer going to be available. There's a supply. I don't know when it will run out, but there will not be any more made. When they run out, if people are asking for it, this color is literally ending. Likewise, the Dixies were always to be a limited number. And some people had simply said, well, we didn't have a chance to get any. Everyone who wanted one has been able to get one now. And these are officially out of production. They haven't been made for a while. And when they sell out, They're not going to be brought back. The number 10 Noodlers is distinguished by a black cap, black end cap, black end jewel, black section, and a rippled barrel. So these are now officially collectible. Should be noted that the other Conrad in clear does not come with an extra rollerball with the brush pen. Only the tortoiseshell comes with both. And that's while supplies last, that will eventually come to an end as well.